implant a pig's brain in a human being, would they remain a human being? Strange question to start with when you're watching a building burning down, but see where it takes you from there. Monsters, also a film about truth and lies, on codes, about Japanese society, on forgiveness also, apologies. So we'll leave you to meditate on all of those things. Let's hope that the jury will enjoy the film. And perhaps Julia Ducournau will like it. She won the Golden Palm for her film Titanium, and she's rather fond of monsters. That's what she said. She said to Thierry Frémaux, thank you for bringing monsters into the Cannes Film Festival. And here we have another monster entering into the Cannes Film Festival with the film by Kore-eda Hirokazu. Director is waving to the photographers and to the crowd. For a young boy starting out in his film career, this must be quite an experience to be on the red carpet, surrounded by people who are shouting out. Sakura, who was on that Golden Palm winning film, is the granddaughter of the 18th Prime Minister of her country. She's an actress, but she comes from a family of politicians. Kore-eda is quite politically engaged, and the president of that country refused to congratulate Kore-eda for his Golden Palm. Here we have the theme music from Monster. Earlier on, I was talking about Ryuichi Sakamoto, who died very recently. He composed the music, so his final film score was for Monster. Sakamoto Ryuichi was in charge of The Last Emperor. He did the music for Furio. He's won Golden Globes and Grammys for his music. So Ryuichi Sakamoto composed 45 film scores and some TV scores as well. And he died in March 2023 at the age of 71. And his final film was Monster. Here we have Thierry Frémaux and Iris Knobloch waiting halfway up the steps, admiring this fine Japanese crew, waiting to greet them. Very well organized red carpet ceremony this evening. Well done to all of the technical team. There we have Nakamaya Eto, and on the screen and in the music, we can hear Sakamoto Ryuichi. The music is absolutely very moving. A final wave, Japanese style. to the crowd. Why did you say that was Japanese style? Well, they just seem to be... It seems to me very Japanese in style. You say when you do it, you look like you're the Queen of England. So here we have the crew from Kore-eda's film Monster. They're entering into the festival hall. The screening this evening is of the first film in competition this year. So there are some more waves, small waves, and some bigger waves.
Qui ouvre la compétition de ce 76e Festival de Cannes. Kore-eda Hirokazu.
Jerry Frimer will lead the way into the festival building. Below the poster of Catherine Deneuve, the entire team will be on row I. Yes, what is row I? Well, row I is the row in the movie theatre where the crew is placed at the end of the screening. The audience all rise to their feet and give a standing ovation, which can last for many minutes. And it gives you a good idea of how well the film has been received. So there are the children going to one side whilst... Oh, calling back the children. They were taking a wrong turn there. There are 2,500 people in the movie theatre. Over 800 people up in the balcony there. So they must be very impressed, those young gentlemen, to experience this. So Ando Sakura, the leading lady, was already in Shoplifters, the film, and so she's very used to having these standing ovations. That was back in 2018, but I'm sure she hasn't forgotten. So bye for now, see you soon. And we'll be back later for another red carpet for the Catherine Corsini film.